often asked a question: which is the best amplifier in the world, and does it exist? In this video, I try to answer to this question. And before we go further, I encourage you to read Bruno Putzeys' latest article. Actually, it's covering all journey of Class D amplifier from nobody to top performers, and making a long discussion short. Today, three companies, Class D audio amplifiers, outperforming human hearing limits so many times that we have best amplifier in the world, and you have plenty of choices. Practically, your key choice is power and price. So here I have a chat with artificial intelligence, do some research, and I asked professional requirements for audio amplifiers used in studio and in live performance. And here is a short summary. Professional recording studio demands that your total harmonic distortions are below 0.1. Why below 0.1? Because 0.25 is a human hearing limit. When we are below 0.5, it's fine. And then high fidelity decided that we should be 10 times better than our human hearing limits at 0.01. And for live performance, 1% is okay, because when you are listening very loud, then our hearing is really losing sensitivity, and then 1% is more than okay. Also, here is answer why you can't use it for home listening or high fidelity listening. Live sound developed amplifiers. They are developed with a different architecture, with different requirements. And then I ask a question about middle field monitors, which are equivalent of floor standards, and mostly I was looking how much power. Yeah, and the average power is about 500 watts, what we need for a woofer. Those are active system, even more efficient, and they need for the bass 500 watts. And if you look at another example, Neumann, which is typical three-way speaker, you can see it has a basic design, square box, now rounded, and some special shapes. And this is a reference studio monitor for recording studios. For a woofer, they have 300 30 watts, class AB, and this is marginally okay, because normally you need about 500 and a little bit more, but with class AB it's very expensive, so here is some compromises. And for mids and tweeters, 100 watts are far then okay. And then I formulate in different way to best possible quality, and then I got an answer that for professional grade studio amplifiers, top of the top, they demand 0.005%, yeah, and there are even some super achievers with a little bit lower. But human hearing limits are 0.1, and the speakers typically provide 1% of distortions. Some top performance 0.1% distortions. So distortion parameter is by far not the most important. And here is also this artificial intelligence put a note even that low THD is desirable, but not only factor of sound quality, and I fully agree with that. And let's look to one professional, well-known studio amplifier for middle field monitors, and Amphion Amp 700, providing 700 watts per channel at 4 ohms, class D. Here it is, selling for 2000. It's a Finnish company, actually well-known Finnish company, and here you can see all the parameters and meeting those 0.00, blah, 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 blah. So everything is here, and if we open a box, ascetic design, here is a ICEpower board in it. Some extra small filterings at the output to meet maybe some tiny requirements, who knows, proprietary preamp. But generally, all quality is defined by the board. And of course, you need a good preamp. And you know, this is the future. Look at simplicity. Look at simplicity. Because all complexity of the design is hidden here. And if you read Bruno Putzeys' article, then you know why. Because this is so complicated to build that only two or three companies in the world currently are capable to build really good Class D amplifier. Because so many tiny things which are not documented and not available for other companies, they keep it in-house as a knowledge. It's how to build a PCB board, because it's very difficult. You have super high power and current pulse together with low level analog signal, and you have a power supply on it, and you should build it in a way that it is a perfect, and this is difficult. Yeah, and majority of Class AB production companies doesn't have inside that knowledge. This knowledge more is in switching mode power supply company than in audio amplifier companies. And here you need those hybrid knowledge. And today there are two large companies. Largest is ICEpower with in-house knowledge, and many manufacturers use their boards in it. Then it's Hypex with a limited lineup. And Bruno Putzeys and Hypex also producing some specific boards, but not integrated ones for DIY audience as well. And then the key message is those very, very low total harmonic distortions in it. So, but look, simplicity, fantastic. I can build it. You can build it as well. And this is past, fantastic equipment. And here it is done in a way how I like it. They are kind of chassis or rack mount. There could be wheels or something else, but it's well equipped. It's easy to serve. But look, thick wires and everything. And Bruno Putzeys in that article also mentioned why it is absolutely nonsense concept. It makes so much trouble, those big cables and interaction with them, that some marketing did a bad job and sold tons of crap for high money. It's not right architecture. It's not right architecture for a future. And here is excellent picture from Macintosh. And I ask myself personal question. If I can get it for free, what I will take from this room. And after some thinking, I come to conclusion that I want only speakers. So super, those are great speakers, or built in a way that I like. It's the right architecture. It's minimalistic, but satisfying any requirements, home requirements for a music. Absolutely great speakers. And I don't want that great audio equipment, because world is changing, electronics is changing, and the big box solutions doesn't have a future. They take too much space, they cost too much money, they are not optimum from electronic engineering concept. And this is how you have been taught for decades, how nice equipment setup should look like, and there are people who spent 10,000 and even more through their life cycle adding components one by one, replacing them. When I looked at a great Macintosh picture, I was impressed about equipment. Macintosh has excellent engineers, but the world is moving forward. I had this feeling the same when I came with my son to Railway Museum in our country. And there was plenty of different locomobiles. But definitely, I was impressed by this steam engine. And we spent a long time here looking at this really state-of-the-art engineering design. And when you read some history of mechanics, a lot about the steam engines, are they great engineering achievements? Yes, they are. But today, we are not using them. We moved forward. And modern trains are better than the steam engine. I'm impressed about steam engine, but this is the past. And this is when I look at those absolutely great devices. So good, so good, so good. But I'm thinking them as a steam engine. And we look at the specs, yeah. And specs are so-so. You can see it was a 7,000 euros worth monoblock. Then you need two of them, or even more. I forget how much they cost, but those are pretty expensive. But it's 100-watt amplifier. Yeah, we can talk all around, but it's 100-watt amplifier. and how much we need for perfect home usage, we need 500 watts. And it's very difficult with class AB, almost impossible, very expensive. But with class D we can. And once we have 500 watts, and don't think that 500 watts is a lot. 500 watts is twice as loud as 100 watts, because we have logarithmic relationship, and to double SPL or sound pressure from 100 watts, we need 400 watts to double. So the 500 watts is pretty okay. And one more thing, when you have 100 watt RMS rated speaker, since there is a crest factor of 8 comparing sine wave RMS to music, that you should multiply by 8. That means 100 multiplied by 8 is 800, that your 100 watt speaker is capable to handle 800 watt music power without problems. It just become more dynamic. Those peaks will move that speaker with confidence and precision. But power you need just for woofer. What happens if you don't have sufficient power? Then you have that popular expression that I have lamp amplifier and I have so good mids and so nice mids. And what is the real reason for that? That bass is suppressed, the mids are more and bass is less, and you have heavy coloration, you are not listening what is recording in studio. If you like, it's fine, but it is a problem. If you are really transparent, that you want to listen what is recorded in the studio, then you need a power. And power was problem, very big problem in the past. And then, coming back to Bruno Putzeys' article, when you want the best amplifier in the world, you have, because latest generation Class D amplifiers with output power of 500 watts, and it depends on your speakers, either it's a 4-ohm or it's a 8-ohm speaker, you need those 500 watts and proper architecture. And it's here, if you look at the specs, meeting all most demanding studio recording, world studio recording requirements, and it's here, and it's integrated in one board, and there is a even buffer preamplifier in it. You don't need a separate as it was in that Amphion board. This is a previous generation board, and they need an additional preamplifier for a best sound. But this ICEpower 100 2000 ICE 2, it's an endgame amplifier. Fully integrated, easy to build something. I will show you on a practice how easy it is to integrate it when you have a dedicated kit or some box. And today everyone in the world can build endgame amplifier, world best amplifier. Yeah, in the future there will be maybe some little bit better specs and PR about it, but it's not working anymore. Also, those who are talking about GunFET and stuff about future of GunFET, read Bruno's article. He's touching this topic, and for power up to 1 kilowatt is meaningless. You can't make it better than in silicon, but then it is by far more expensive. The GunFETs are okay or pays back when you're building solutions about 2-3 kilowatts, but it's not for home usage. For home usage, you don't need a 2.3 kilowatts. So today we have audio amplifier that satisfies in all aspects. And for industry is bad, because when you have something so perfect, then you need something new to sell. Otherwise, everyone will just take this board and be happy. And it's bad for industry. They are losing money. For Macintosh, it's becoming really difficult to sell products. They have massive marketing, but you as a DIY or do-it-yourself guys can build even better quality than they can. When we talk about the power, which power really means for us, we as a home user or home listener, we want this flat total harmonic distortion region. And for that particular ICEpower 1200 board, you can get about 450 per channel out with absolutely perfect total harmonic distortions. Here it is headroom, and this is usable. And this is sufficient for any home usage scenario. Those boards are built so reliable, so with so low noise, that you can use it for near field monitors, you can use it for mid field monitors, you can use it for large flow standards, you can use it for anything. And frequency characteristics are crazy flat. Even at 20 kilohertz, just a 0.5 decibel drop, what is inaudible. Here our hearing sensitivity is very low, and majority of people even don't hear it, and there is no music. Yeah. So it is absolutely flat for all aspects. Let's take a closer look at the board.